Hello everybody. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up the Google Calendar Sync feature with the Simply Schedule Appointments plugin. So I'm starting off here with my test site, and I'm going to head on over to the Appointments tab on the left-hand side on the WordPress dashboard. And this is going to open the Simply Schedule Appointments admin dashboard. And from here, I'm going to head on over to the Settings tab, and we're going to scroll down, and your Google settings might be grayed out, but we can just toggle them on if you're on a premium edition. And I'm going to click edit. And here we're going to collect the client ID and the client secret, and we'll need to do that from the Google Cloud Platform, I believe that's what it's called. And it's going to be under this URL, console.cloud.google.com. It's a mouthful. And so I've already gone and opened up my Cloud Platform page. And this is what it should look like. You might land on another part of this platform, but what we're going to be looking at is this little select a project tab up here at the top. So this is where we're going to get started, regardless of what page you get put under. So I'm going to select a project, and the first thing we want to do is create a new project. And so here we'll need to name this anything you want. You can name it like your website, and then sync so you can keep yourself organized. But in this case, I'm just going to call it my booking calendar sync API. And for the organization, if you're just using a regular Gmail email address, you can go ahead and leave this as an organization. If you are using Google Suite, you might need to come into the browsing tab and select your Google Suite organization account here. And if you were given an email address from a Google Suite owner, then you may need to request more permissions from that Google Suite owner in order to create a project. So let's go ahead and create this. And it's going to take a moment. As soon as I see this project listed here at the top, that's a good indication that we can probably just go ahead and refresh the page. Great. So this is what the dashboard looks like. And I know I'm in the right spot if it says my project name here at the top. And we can even click into it and double check we're selected in the right project. Alrighty. So from here, we're going to want to head on over to the APIs and services tab on the side, and it looks like mine is pinned over here, but if you're having some trouble finding it from the dashboard, you can also come down here and click Explore and Enable APIs. Perfect. So from here, we're in the APIs and Services dashboard, and we're going to want to head on over to the library. And you're going to want to search Google Calendar. And it's going to be this one at the top, Google Calendar API. So after clicking into this, you go ahead and click on Enable. And just give it a moment and I'll redirect you. So after we are back on the screen here, you're gonna wanna create the credentials. So that's gonna be on the top right corner right now. And then we'll begin creating our first OAuth credential. That's what it's called. So we want to make sure we're on the right API, so Google Calendar API. And then for these radio buttons, go ahead and click User Data and click Next. Alrighty, next, for the app name, again, you can do something like your website name, sync, Google Calendar sync. In this case, I'm just going to call it My Booking Calendar Sync. And then for the support email, go ahead and select your email address. And the same goes for the developer contact information. That's going to be your address as well. And click Save and Continue. And then for this scope section, go ahead and click Add Scopes. And then we're going to look up Google Calendar API. And I'm going to click out of this carefully. And so now we'll see Google Calendar APIs. There's going to be a bunch listed, but we only need to select this very top one, the one that says /auth/calendar. Some of these other ones are a little bit more lengthy, but this is the only one we want. And then we're going to scroll all the way to the bottom and click update. It's a little hidden for some screen sizes. Alrighty, so as you can see, we have our calendar API scope added, and we're going to go ahead and click save and continue. Alrighty, for the OAuth client ID, this is a web application type. So click that first one, and we're going to type in any name here that you want. And then there is two options here to add URIs. This one's the JavaScript origins and then the redirect URIs. Please make sure we're using this one here. This one will not work for you. So under the authorized redirect URIs, go ahead and enter your website URL. And in my case, it is this top one right here. So let me go ahead and copy this and go back. So here I will enter my website's URL, including the HTTPS part, and then we'll go ahead and click create. Again, please make sure you're using the redirect URIs section, not this top one. All right, so create. And that's it for that first part. So I have the client ID collected. I can copy it to my clipboard and go back to Simply Schedule Appointments. And as you can see here, this is where I can enter it. Now we'll have to still go back and collect the secret, so I'll go ahead and click done. And then from here, I can go to the credentials tab. And here where it says booking calendar client, this is the one I just created right under the OAuth portion. So I'll click here, and then there is the client secret right here. So I'll go ahead and copy that as well. And we'll go back. And from here, we can go ahead and save and authorize. And as you can see, we are back to the Google sign-in screen, and I'll go ahead and sign in with my email, FoxySSA. Okay, so good error to run into. We'll go back and fix this really quick. So save. We'll want to go to OAuth consent screen. And if you see here, we'll have to make sure this is published. So click publish app. And it will say it needs verification, but no worries. You do not need to fill this out. This is for testing purposes. And Google actually outlines that WordPress plugins for personal use do not need to go through this verification process. So I'll go back here. We'll go back one screen. Try signing in again, and this is expected. Google hasn't verified this app. This is perfectly normal. Go ahead and click advanced, and then go ahead and go to your website from that little link down there, and then click continue. Perfect. Now you can see that your account is connected. This is your email address, should be listed up here, and then that should be it as far as connecting to Google. I want to show you another error that we tend to see people run into. So let me go ahead and disconnect here, go back to my credentials tab, and then go to the booking calendar client. So Google can be quite picky about this redirect URI here. And usually it just tends to be maybe like a forward slash, or maybe you just need to add your www portion of your website URL. So let me show you what that error looks like. So if I go ahead and save and authorize this time, you'll see this 400 redirect URI mismatch. And what that tells me is that my website URL is not quite in the right format that Google wants it to be, but you can always click here, request more details, and then whatever this URL is here, we can copy and we can take it back, and we'll want to go to the redirect URL URI field and replace it with the one that we had. So little things like this, Google can get picky about and throw that 400 error, but you can always go back and edit it. And try to tweak it, see what works best for you. Sometimes it's a forward slash, sometimes it's a www. Or you can just go ahead and try copying in the URI that they list here and see how that works. But I'm going to save that and we'll see that it's fixed after that. Save and authorize. And again, we're taken back to that same screen. And we can finish setting up. So go ahead and continue. And we're back to where we started. If you see here, we have a couple of other options in the settings screen that you may find helpful. We have the Google Meet web meetings toggle here. If you'd like to set up your meetings through Google Meet, you can toggle this on. Another option here is to delete the canceled or rescheduled events from Google Calendar. For example, if someone cancels here on your website, they can automatically be deleted from your Google Calendar so you don't have any confusion. And then the other part here is the refresh Google Calendars portion. This is how often Simply Schedule Appointments is going to check your calendars for conflicts. Not necessarily to sync. The syncing part is automatic and instant. This is only to check for conflicts. And last but not least, we're going to need to finish setting this up on our appointment types. So this was just the first portion of the setup. We'll need to finish setting up in our appointment types. So here is my appointment type, consultation phone call. And every time I get a booking through this, I want my Google Calendar to be updated. So a quick recap here. I think I went too fast. Go ahead and just click into your appointment type, scroll down to the Google Calendar tab, and then select the calendars that you'd like to sync to. So anytime a booking comes in, it will instantly be written to my calendar under this email address. And I can also invite the customer to the event so that they can also have this automatically added to their calendar. And then another option here, check these calendars for conflicts. So if I have like a dentist appointment written in my Google Calendar, I would like it to block off my time slots here on the consultation phone call, for example. So I'd want to get this calendar selected to check for conflicts. And we can actually test this out here in a second, and then go ahead and save. And for testing purposes, I'm going to set this to 1 minute. Alrighty, and we're going to test an appointment just to see how that works. I have my Google Calendar page pulled up, so let's book an appointment. Alrighty, so I have some openings here on Friday. Let's pick an appointment. And book. Alrighty, this was booked April 1st at 8 a.m. So let's go check our calendar. And here it is, John, my blog, consultation phone call. And this is the information provided. And we just released a customization feature so you can edit these. And I can leave a description or a link down in the description below as well. But let's go ahead and test this out with the blocking feature. So let's pick a good day. So on April 1st, we do have availability from 12 to 3:30. So let's make a blocking event here from 12 to 4. I think that's it. Sure. Dentist appointment, and we want to make sure this is set to busy or else SSA will not pick up on it. And we can go ahead and save, and that should block off the corresponding times on our calendar. So let's give it a moment and we can come back to this. All right, Friday, April 1st. Nope, still not yet. And remember, this is because Simply Schedule Appointments checks this on 1 minute intervals. So if you just give it a second, it should be blocked off here in a moment. There we go. So Simply Schedule Appointments was checking your Google Calendar every minute. It saw that it had this dentist appointment and it said, okay, it looks like you're busy, so I'm going to remove those time slots. And that's what the checking for calendar conflicts setting is for. And that should be it, folks. Let me know if you guys have any questions in the comments below, or feel free to reach out to our support email. I hope this was helpful, and have a nice day. Bye-bye.